Good morning, everybody. This is Gail, and I'm proud to be a guest designer for Tupelo Designs LLC, where you can get all of your crafting needs, and shipping is always free in the U.S. One thing about Tupelo that I really appreciate is their customer loyalty rewards. When you sign up with Tupelo to buy something, you create an account, and when you create an account, you get 500 points just for creating your account. Well, that equals $5 that you can immediately take off of your very first order. Shipping in the United States is always free. It's discounted internationally, so you can't get much better than that. Free product and free shipping. And their customer service is great. If you have a concern or a problem, if you will send an email to the email link that's on the website, you will get a reply back from one of the owners in no longer than 12 hours, and usually it's a lot quicker than that. But let's get started on today's project. I am going to be going to the beach in a couple of weeks, and there is a turtle hospital there that takes in sick and injured sea turtles, rehabilitates them, and then releases them back into the wild. And every year when I get ready to go, I think, gosh, I meant to make something that I could donate to their cause, and I never do it. So I decided I would make some sea turtles, and this is going to be an experiment for me. I've never done this before. I have looked at some other tutorials on YouTube, and I've gotten some great ideas, and, you know, I appreciate those people. If I could pin it down to one person, then I would give them credit, but there are so many people that I have gotten inspiration from. But to all of you, thank you very much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with translucent clay. And this is your Sculpey white translucent, about a 2-ounce package. It's rolled out to the thickest setting on my pasta machine. And I'm going to cut this into sections. I think maybe 4 sections. Maybe 5 sections. Because this project does not require a lot of clay. But what I think I'm going to do is tint my clay with alcohol inks and make different colors, and then make different color turtles. So we shall see how this turns out. So let me show you first how to tint with alcohol inks. And you notice I'm wearing gloves. Unless you want your fingers to be dyed a particular color, you might want to consider wearing gloves. And alcohol inks are very, very strong pigmented. And this is a brown. You know, they have brown sea turtles. Sea turtles are usually either brown or green or a combination of the two, maybe with a little bit of grayish color put in there, but I think I'll make a brown sea turtle. So I'm going to put some alcohol ink on that piece. That will be the brown. I better leave it out. And let's see, I'd like to have a blue. Actually, I like that one too. Do I have a blue? I think I do somewhere. There's a blue. So I'll leave that out. And this is a pretty lime green. You can buy the Adirondack alcohol inks at Tupelo. Let's see, I've got 2 more colors. How about Do they have red? They don't probably don't have red, but you know, somebody might want a red sea turtle. Let's do a red. And orange. That ought to pretty much cover. Ooh, this one is dried up. Haven't used the orange very much. I'm not an orange person usually. Now, I don't want a particularly strong color. Let me dust this. I don't want a particularly strong color. I would like to just have, you know, some subtle colors. Well, that brown looks purple, doesn't it? That's okay. I like purple too. I'm just going to spread it out a little bit so that the color, so this will dry, because it's good to have this dried. And unfortunately, with polymer clay, you can't dry things with the heat gun, because it would start baking your clay. So you kind of have to wait for it to dry on its own. And let me get me a paper towel and wipe my rubber gloves off, or I'm still going to get ink all over everything, even if it's not on my fingers. Let me just let this dry a little bit. You don't want to put too much that's wet inside your polymer clay. So try to, it doesn't have to be totally dry, but you just don't want moisture inside your clay other than what's already there. Usually alcohol inks don't take long to dry because they are primarily alcohol. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to go off camera for a little while, make sure this dries. I'll go ahead and blend these, and then we'll get started making our turtles. Okay, I'm back, and all my colors are blended. I've cleaned up my pasta machine from all the ink that got on the pasta machine. But the size of sea turtles that I'm going to make are going to be small enough that you could wear as a pendant. And I needed to get some graduated sizes of balls of clay. So I got out my Kemper cutters, but any kind of cutter that, you know, in order for me to make these small enough, my largest circle needed to be like an inch. Now these are all rolled at the thickest setting of my pasta machine. And I'm going to cut one of the 1 inch, and I believe this is 3/4 of an inch. I'm measuring these as I go. I should have done that beforehand. So this one is probably 3/8 of an inch, and I'm going to cut two of these. Actually, I'm going to cut three of these. And that's all I need to make my first turtle. Now, what I'm going to do with one of these circles is I'm going to cut it in half and put half on this one, which will be my third. And then I'll use just one single one for my last little ball, and that gives you a half left over, which you can make another sea turtle. If you want to do two of them, you can. I'm just doing one of each color right now, but when I'm not on camera, I will probably be doing more. So now all you do is you take your balls of clay and you just make them into a little ball. You can do, you know, mash it with your fingers and then just roll it in the palm of your hand. And if you roll down in this cup part of your palm, it will help to keep it round. If you go to the outside part of your hand, it'll make it more oval shaped. In this case, it doesn't really matter. What I'm going to do is make it slightly teardrop shaped. And I'm going to mash it, not a whole lot, but just enough. Let me do it here. And I know this will be upside down for you if I can remember to flip my video when I post it. But you just want to make this into a little shell. And you want it to be dimensional, so you don't want it to be real flat. You want it to be rounded up. And this has a little mark on it, but that's going to be okay. But this is going to be the main part of my turtle. Now the second one, I think I said it was a 3/4 inch circle. And we'll do the same thing. We're going to rub that into a little ball. And make that into a teardrop. And this is going to be his head. So the first thing I'm going to do, and let me do this a little closer so you can see. While you're holding on to this flat part, just pinch a little bit on each side. And then, you know, pinch a little, not a big point, but just a little bit of a point to be his nose, and then flatten a place on top, which is his forehead. And that gives you a little turtle head. And then what you do is you put it on your work surface and flatten this piece as flat as you can get it. And then place it under your shell. And then I take just, you know, whatever tool you have to smooth. Just try to smooth it out, and that gets it really nice and attached. Plus it looks nice on the back. You always want it to look nice on the back, and you can smooth it with your finger. But you're going to be adding other things, so you want to smooth that at the end. Now what I like to do at this point is also to pinch a little tail. And I know this is part of the shell, but if you can keep this little point down at the bottom part of the shell before you attach the legs, you can take your same tool that you use to smooth out, and just right above where that tail is, let me get back in the frame. See my little tail? Right above where the tail is, start making a line so that kind of separates the shell from his lower body. And that way the tail isn't part of the shell. You can also do this with a toothpick. Let me show you how to do it with a toothpick. You can just take a toothpick and just press around with a toothpick. You don't have to have fancy tools when you work with polymer clay. I think I told you about the lady that I met that did beautiful, beautiful things, and all she used was a razor blade and a toothpick. But take this ridge all the way up to the neck. You don't have to go around the neck, but anyway, that kind of separates the shell from his body. And make sure you keep this the shell round. Don't let it flatten out on you when you're doing all this. If you do, just kind of push it back where it's supposed to be. There. Okay, now probably needs to be a little fatter. There. So okay, so we take the next one, which is 1.5 of the 3/8 circles, and you don't have to use these. You can use any cutter that you've got. You can even just make little balls by hand, as long as you've got 4 graduated sizes. the larger one down to a smaller one. It doesn't matter. But anyway, take this one and roll it into a log. And then cut it in half. And these are going to be the front flippers. So then just take this and in your hands, form it into like a little triangle, a little fat triangle, if you want to call it that. And it doesn't have to be exact at this point, because all it's doing is giving you the primary shape. Then put it on your work surface and press it flat. And you can take your tool, you can take your finger, you can take whatever, and just create a little flipper shape. And see which side. Mine turned out a little bit opposite what I was planning. So I think I'm going to use this as the flipper, so I'm going to mash that side flat. And do the same thing with the other one. Turn it into a little flat, not flat, fat triangle, just to give it your beginning shape. And then press it down on your work surface. And then form another little fin flipper. This one's got to face the other way, so I need to work on this side. And then flatten this side. Now what you're going to do with these is you're going to, got a little mark on my shell from probably my thumbnail. I need to trim my nails. Find out how you want it to look, and I think that looks cute right there. And just press it onto the bottom of your shell. And again, we're going to smooth that out. Not only are you making it look nice, but you're making sure that that little fin won't come off. And then we'll do the same thing with the other one. Find a place for it. And it can be symmetrical with the other one. You can have it out a little bit further. It doesn't really matter. Because when turtles are swimming, they don't stay symmetrical. So let me smooth this one in. Let me set it down for you. And you might want to press them in a little bit. You know, you don't want them sticking out too far, because if this is worn as a pendant, we'll see. Don't want it sticking out too far. Keep messing up the shape of my shell. So then the back one, of course, is going to be the last little, the smallest ball that you've made. And you see how big this is next to a dime. People have asked me why I keep a dime on my work surface. And it's so people can see size in relation to things. See, that's how small the tiniest ball is. Doesn't have to be very big. But again, you're going to roll it into a log. Let me come out just a little bit and cut it in half. And you're going to roll these into a teardrop. don't want it to be too long. Sometimes I have a heavy hand. And then just press it flat. And then the pointed ends, you're going to press really flat so that they will fit up underneath your turtle. And I'll go ahead and put both of these on. And guess what we do now? We blend the back. That noise you hear is one of my greyhounds that decided to come in here and help me clay. And she can't seem to find a place she wants to lay because this craft room is a mess. But there's the basis for our little sea turtle. But, you know, sea turtles have designs on their backs. And let me see. You can do this a couple of different ways. I usually use a Kemper cutter, again, because I love Kemper cutters. You can take this, which is a heart, and it's about 3/8 of an inch, a little bit less than 3/8 of an inch, maybe it's just 1/4 of an inch. And if you can line it up, which I'm not that great at, so I probably should do this manually. Just kind of press, don't do a cut, just press the design down into his shell. And then you can take a toothpick or a ball tool. That's probably a better thing to use, would be a ball tool. Let me see which one I want to use. Let me use this one. And just press around. You can draw this if you're good at freehand drawing. You can draw your little heart. And then go over it with the ball tool. And it doesn't have to be a heart. You can do circles. You can do rectangles. And where you separated the shell from the body, you can go around that with your ball tool also, just to add some definition to the bottom of the shell. And you don't want to go into the leg, of course, because the leg is not in the shell. It comes from outside the shell. And just go up to the neck. And hopefully you still have this. If you've lost your definition for your head, you can just make a little indent there, but I think we're fine. And then take your ball tool and just draw lines down from your heart down to that line that separates the shell from the body. And this gives you the separations that you see in turtle shells. Okay, we're almost done. At least with everything that you do before you bake it. But you've got to give him some eyes. So take your ball tool, and if you have different sizes, take a tiny little ball tool and put Mark two little holes for his eyes. And I always keep black on my work surface because you can always use a teeny tiny piece of black on something. So just roll a teeny teeny tiny snake out of the black and cut off a little tip. Can you see that? How little that is? That's all you need for his eye. And what I'm going to do is just take the tip of the toothpick and pick it up and put it in that little hole and make sure that it's attached. So at least now our little turtle can see. Oh, I forgot to get one thing out. I'm so used to, I don't do jewelry very often, but I need to get like a little eye pin or a screw eye. So hold just a minute. I'm going to go off camera while I find that. Sorry about that. I decided I'm going to use these little screw eyes that I have in my stash. I believe these are Tim Holtz. And I'm going to screw only because I want to make sure they get into the clay really good. There. So now that there's something I can hang him by, I'll keep that black clay out for my next turtle. And my turtle has managed to get a little out of shape, but I think he'll still be all right. Now, before I put him in the oven, I'm going to use some perfect pearls and a brush. I got a fine brush. I'm going to take some of the brown. I believe it's called cappuccino. And just kind of brush it around these little indents. Let me put some on my lid here. See how this works. If this doesn't work, then I can always antique it with some paint after it's baked. But I thought I would try the perfect pearls just to add a little bit of shimmer. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I don't know how I could forget. It's a huge sale. Tupelo is having a sale this weekend, and I know you won't see this until Monday, but it's through Monday, so hopefully you'll be able to see this. They have 5% or $5 off of a $50 purchase, which is 10% off. Then they have $15 off of a $100 purchase, and then $30 off of a $150 purchase, and that's 30% off. So it's a pretty good deal. You can get, depending on the size of your purchase. So now would be a great time to stock up on your polymer clay. You can get your They carry two different types of alcohol inks. They carry the Tim Holtz, and they also carry Adirondack, which are both really good alcohol inks. Then carry your clay. So this would be a good time to stock up on your clay. Now, I don't know. I'm back to this. I put the brown on my green lid. But I thought I would add some green shimmer to the shell. And just put it right over top of the brown, just so that they kind of blend together. I'm trying not to get it on the turtle. I just want to put it on the shell. And I may still antique it after it's baked. But there's my little turtle. Let me pick it up. I don't know. I don't think it's attached too bad. But before it bakes, you can tweak it a little. You can put your fins in a different position. And what I would do, just being me, I would get a little stamp or something with my initials on it and maybe put 16 for 2016 and just have the little stamp. But that's my green one. I think he turned out pretty good. And he'll go on my tile to bake. And I think I'll make one more, since it really doesn't take long to make these. I'm going to make one more. And maybe use the blue, or this brown ended up being a real pretty purple. I could use that. It doesn't really matter. I could use anything. But I think I will use the blue. And just to show you, you don't have to have cutters. I'm just going to make little balls. I just remember the first ball was about the size of a marble, which is maybe a little bit bigger than this. Let me mash it good first. That's a good size. Then take one not quite as big, just to show you can do it without cutters. There's another one. And then just a little bit less. A little bit smaller, not much. That's good. I'll just make this one small. See, just to show you, you don't have to be exact. See, there's my four balls. And let me wipe the perfect pearls off my work surface. But you see, it doesn't take much clay. I didn't have much clay to begin with, and I still have this left over. I can probably make two more turtles out of that blue. So let's go back to making the shell. Make it a slight teardrop. And then press to make it the shape of a shell. Take your second one, your second ball, and just kind of make a little neck on one end, and this is going to be his head. Pinch on either side. And then pinch from the top to bottom to make his nose. And then flatten the little hump that ends up being there, because they have this flat place on their head. Then flatten this. And put it on the bottom of your shell. And blend. And I'm not worrying about it being smooth yet because I've got other things I'm going to need to smooth. Now before I add his legs, I want to pinch a little tail. It doesn't have to be very big, just a little point is good. And then I'm going to go ahead, since I got my ball tool out, I'm going to use my ball tool to make the little line just down near the bottom. Start at the top of the tail and just work your way around. And it doesn't have to be smooth. Just keep dotting and it'll make a line. I kind of like the dotted line effect. Come across the top, which shows you that his tail is not part of the shell. And then go up the other side. There you go. And this seems to be where I get my shell out of shape. So let me just make it fatter before I put the legs on. Take your third ball, make a log, cut it in half for the two flippers. And then you make your fat triangle. Let me turn it over because there's a little speck on that one, on that side. And you can probably even use your ball tool to kind of create this little bend. Just use the side of it. Don't use the ball, use the side of it. Anything, you can use the end of a paintbrush. Here's a paintbrush that I'm using for the perfect pearls. You can use that. Just anything to help you make that little V. And I think I'm going to make this side the fin. So this side I'm going to mash down. And do the same thing with the other half. Form your fat triangle. And mash it down a little bit. And then use your paintbrush or, like I say, whatever you've got to make the little bend. And then mash this side. See where you want to put them. You can and each turtle you make is going to be different, which is good. You don't want them all to be like production type things. Just reshape your fin however you want it. I think I want it to come in a little bit closer. And then pick it up and blend. You can also blend with your ball tool if you have one of those. You just take that and blend it in. Sorry, I just started thinking again, and you know I can't think and talk and clay all at the same time. And I might smooth that out a little bit. Okay, now we take the smallest ball, and again, you make it into a little log and cut it in half. Roll each half into a teardrop. And then mesh and press the little end. And just, you don't want to mash the flipper part real flat. You just want it to be a little bit flatter. You don't want it to be perfectly round. And I think that's a good place for it. Let me see if I can get the other one on there without having to turn it back over. And blend. See, it doesn't take long to make these little turtles. And hopefully by doing two of them, if you missed anything on the first one, you saw it better on the second one. And then put it down and just look at all your flippers. Make sure they're where you want them. And this time I think I'm going to just make my heart with my ball tool. I'm not really good at drawing, but you don't have to be good. And it doesn't, like I said, it doesn't have to be a heart. The heart idea I did get from somebody else. I would have just used little rectangles or circles, but I didn't write her name down. But I will certainly give her credit in the description box below. And I'll put all of the codes. There are codes for these discounts. And like the code for the $5 off of $50 is $5. The $15 off of $100 is $15. And the code for $30 off $150 is $30. And I will put all of those in the description box below. And hopefully you will view this video early on Monday and you can take advantage of the sale before the day is over. Okay, so now it's time to make my little lines. This one I don't think I'll use perfect pearls. I think I'm going to wait until after it's baked and maybe use some Inca gold just to see the difference. Since I'm kind of learning along with you this time, I don't know which will work best, so I'm going to try both. There. Now to turn him around and give him some eyes. He's got a real pointy nose, doesn't he? Let me fix that before we bake him. Anyway, I'll put an eye there. I'll make this eye these eyes a little bit bigger than the last one I did. Roll my black into a little teeny tiny snake. Cut off a small piece and roll it into a little ball. So little I can't even feel it in my hand. There it is. And then put the little eyes in the hole. something else I will do. This is just the shell of a ballpoint pen. I've taken the ballpoint cartridge out of it, and I use this little end here to make little circles. And I think I will, and I'll get the green one also. I think I'm going to put little circles on his fins and on his head, just to give it some texture and make it look a little bit more realistic. And I'm just going to dot the top of his head, maybe down to here. Let me get my green one. I'd already put him on my baking dish, but let me do that on him. But now that you see them side by side, you can see that they're totally different. And every one I make is going to be different. Every one you make is going to be different. There's no way when you do something handmade that they can be identical. I think I'm going to like that. Okay, I have another somewhere. I have another little eye thing that I took out, and I probably have it stuck to my clay somewhere. I can get another one. You see, that's what I'm talking about when I say a screw eye. See how tiny that is? Just a little tiny eye with a screw end on it. And I'm putting it through his nose because I can't imagine anybody would want to wear it upside down. But there's my little blue one. So see what you can do. I will make some more, and if I get them done before I post this on Monday, I will put a picture at the end of my, either at the end of the video, or I will make the picture my thumbnail for the video, just so you can see what they turned out after they're baked, because being translucent clay, they're going to look a little different when they're baked. Or actually, I probably need to come back and show you how I'm going to use the Inca Gold, so I'll do that. So let me bake these two, and then I will be back as soon as they're out of the oven and cool. Thanks. Okay, everyone. I've got my little turtles out of the oven, and my green one looks a little misshapen. So what I think I'm going to do now is, let me put a little bit of water in my Inca Gold. It's kind of dried up a little bit. But what I think I'm going to do is to antique this with some black clay. And that will highlight the little grooves in here. And then I'll wipe that off, and then I will add some Inca Gold or something to make it sparkly. So I'm going to, I don't need much. I'm going to just put a little bit of black on my tile, and I'm going to add water to it, because you don't want planks, you know, pure black paint. Just mix that up. and put it all over the little turtle. And you think, I've gone to all that trouble. To make this little turtle, and then I'm painting it black. Sorry, I just had a little bit of a motor pause there. But then I'm going to take the paper towel and I'm going to wipe it off. And you'll notice that the paint stays down in the little grooves. Actually, this might be a little bit too watery. I didn't add enough paint, and I ended up wiping it all off. Because you do need some color that will stay down in those little grooves. I had it a little bit too watery. And you might just let it sit for just a minute. I'm just letting it sit for a minute, and then just with a dry paper towel, just wipe it off. And you see all those little circles that I put in on the head and on the legs, the flippers. It's all now got this black paint in there. And you can remove as much of it as you want. And I want to remove most of it. The only paint I want to leave is what's down in the little grooves. There you go. So let me just wipe this off real quick before the paint dries on my tile. And you can see I'm ready to make some more turtles. I've got one more green to do and one more blue. And then I've got the two reds, two purples. But in the meantime, let me get rid of that. So now I've got the little, I'm going to put a deeper blue. I'm going to put a deeper blue on here, and this is the Inca Gold. And you see how it's going to add some shimmer. Because what I ended up doing with the, I don't want quite that much, but what I ended up doing with the black was dulling it down. So now I've still got the black in the grooves, but I can add some Inca Gold. To the top. And there's our little turtle, all ready to go onto a necklace or a keychain. I think I'll put some of this Inca Gold on the bottom since it looks so pretty. And just let that dry, and we'll have our little sea turtle. And with the little eyelet there, you can string it on a chain. You can put a cord through it. There are lots of things you can do. I may even take a little of this blue here out of the grooves. But I think that turned out really pretty. Let me come in a little closer. There you go. And there's our little sea turtle. Isn't that cute? I just think it's adorable. And I'm going to do as many colors, like I said, I've got many. I've got this green. And I do have a green. Although I think what I need to do is I need to antique this one also. I don't think the brown that I put on there before is really going to be good enough. And there's enough water left on this brush that I can just add a little bit of paint. And see what this does to the green. And just pounce it with your brush. Don't use a good brush, because you're going to be ruining it if you do. But just pounce so that the black gets down in all the little grooves. This one was a little bit more difficult than the other one. And then wipe it off. Here, you can get really messy. And that's okay, because it's fun. I just don't want this drying and interfering with anything else I do here. Luckily, I keep a paper towel roll right handy. So that's antiqued. And now let me see about this green. It's a little dry, so let me add some green, some water to it. One thing about your Inca Gold, it will dry out. But because it's water-based, you can just add water to it and it brings it right back. So I'm just going to go over this and highlight the top of it and leave the black in the sides. Put some on the bottom. And there's the green one. It really changed the look of it, didn't it? So there's two little turtles that I've made, and I'll continue to make these. And what I plan on doing is donating these to the Karen Beasley Sea Turtle Rehabilitation Hospital, I think is the name of it. They're down in Surf City, North Carolina. And I go down there and visit every year. And every year I say I'm going to donate something to their gift shop, and this is what I decided I would do. And I'm going down in a couple of weeks. I'm really excited. My sister and I go down every September. So we're looking forward to it. And this year my daughter's going with us, so we're going to have a really good time this year. But oh, and I've got some other news. Let me get my email, because this is something that just came today, so you will be the first to hear. I've got a little teaser for you, and it's going to, you know, this is what it is. You know, we've got a new product coming out, and I can't tell you what it is because it's so big that they don't want us to let you know ahead of time, but it's going to include a prize package. Excuse me, I'm sorry. But very soon, Tupelo Designs LLC will be rolling out a new product line in the store. It's one we're very proud to carry, so to celebrate, we'll be having a kickoff hop. I can't tell you any more than this yet, but stay tuned. Watch for more information in the newsletter and on my channel to be coming out very soon. So, What I would do if I were you is I would go to the Tupelo Designs LLC website and sign up for their newsletter, and so that you'll know when this product comes out, and you know, this, that we start, when we start carrying this product line, I think everybody would be very happy with it. So, you know, check it out. Go to Tupelo. Don't forget the sale this weekend. It ends tonight. So, you know, go check out what's there now. And then when the new products come out, if you pay attention to my channel or watch the Tupelo Designs newsletter when it comes out, you'll be the first to know. So thanks. Have a great week. And I'll see you next Monday for Tupelo Designs LLC. Thanks. Bye-bye.